Hello all, today we will see a very simple mapping wherein we will transfer the data from Oracle database to Teradata database. So in the Oracle database we will have employees table, similar employees table we will create in the Teradata database. So in the mapping is very basic, so we will not have any other transformation apart from source qualifier and the target definition. The few extra things which we will do in the mapping is, we will create a mapping parameter. So that mapping parameter will assign a value of the SQL query. So in the source qualifier transformation will not have any source SQL query value. Rather than that, we'll define a mapping parameter name in the source qualifier, and to that mapping parameter will give this select star from employees, this SQL query value. Similarly, we'll define two session parameters, and one is for source connection and other one is for target connection. So source connection will be XC, that is the database of Oracle, and target connection will be manufacturing database of Teradata. CTU manufacturing. So before creating a mapping, actual mapping, will create a employees table at Teradata DB first. Okay, so at SQL assistance, so I think we'll have this. We'll drop this table. The table is already exist. Okay, we'll create a table at manufacturing DB. So currently we have connected at manufacturing DB. Create table employees. Call one varchar 1000. So column 2, column 3, column 4, column 5, column 6, 7, 8, 9, 8, 9 and 10. So table is created. Select star from employees. So as of now there are no rows in employees table. So when you create any table in the Teradata database and if you don't define any index on it, Teradata will automatically create index on the first column which we'll define. So in this case, call one is the first column. We'll verify whether index really got created on call one table or not, call one column or not. So that will verify at indices view. So indices view is at DBC database. So we'll prefix that DBC value. Where table name equal to employees. So if you see on call one column, index got created, which is the primary index of employees table in the manufacturing database. So we have done with the database creation, table creation. We'll create a mapping now. So we'll import source and target tables first. Source is the Oracle database. Source is from Oracle database. HR schema, employees table. Similarly, we'll import the target, that will be from Teradata DB. So we have created a system DSN, and manufacturing is our database name. DBC and DBC are the password. Connect manufacturing DB, table is employees. We'll create a mapping now. Underscore Oracle to Teradata. Okay, our mapping will be very simple. We'll have source qualifier and directly a target. We'll create a mapping parameter that will be for our source qualifier query. SQL query type will be parameter, length will be 1000. We'll assign that parameter name to our source qualifier variable. Mapping parameter SQL query, apply. Okay, save the mapping. Mapping is in valid state. We'll create a workflow now. Workflow create WF Oracle to Terra data. Create a session task S underscore Oracle to Terra data. Link the two tasks which we have created. Task link. Okay, now it's time to create a parameter file. So just go to the help in the workflow and over there just search for mapping parameter. In that you will get a section or a topic as parameter file structure. So in that, just come to last. Over here in the parameter file example section, they have given the basic example of parameter file. We'll just copy that and we'll edit that thing only. Notepad. So here production was there folder name, in our case it's ASA, and thing after dot is the session name. So we'll just copy our session name, that is S underscore Oracle to Terra data. We have created mapping parameter. We'll copy that mapping parameter. Mapping parameter value is select star from hr.employees. Now thing remaining is the connection name. So we need two connections, one is for target and another is for source. So go to the workflow again. Connection, relational collection, connection. First create the Oracle connection. New. Our Oracle database is HR or XE. Username is HR. Password. Okay, forgot to give the connection string, that is XE. Similar way, create a Terra data connection. New. Our database name is manufacturing. Username is DBC. Password is DBC. Database name and data source name is manufacturing. So we have done with the session parameter. Oh, sorry, connection creation. The target value is manufacturing and source is XE. We'll save the parameter file Oracle to raw data. We'll define this parameter file path at workflow level. So our parameter file is currently at location. C: Informatica. Okay. Go to the workflow edit, properties, and copy the parameter file name. Now assign the connection values. So our connection value for target was db connection underscore target. I think this was for target. And for source it will be db connection underscore source. So we have created the parameter file. We have defined three values in it. Those are, first is the mapping parameter and remaining two was session parameters. So manufacturing XE and the query which we have defined, we have given those session parameter values at session level. We'll save the workflow. Workflow is in valid state. We'll run the workflow. Session is running. Okay, so if you see over here, source qualifier has faced 107 records and same number of records got inserted at target definition or target level. We'll just verify the session log. So if you see, db connection source got expanded to XE, db connection target got expanded to manufacturing, SQL query got expanded to select star from HR employees, and similar way source qualifier has fetched records from the query which we have specified at parameter file. Okay, we'll just verify at target level whether really record got inserted or not. Select star from employees. Records 2 got inserted. We'll count the number of records. So there are totally 107 records. Now, as we have seen earlier, Teradata by default create an index on the first column if we don't specify any. So we'll just verify. We'll run the same workflow again. So basically this workflow should get fail or record shouldn't get inserted at target table. We'll just verify it. Workflow is currently running. So source qualifier query returned 107 records, but records are going in as a reject rows. They are not getting inserted at target table. We'll just validate the reason. So the error is duplicate row error. That means as the records are already there and there is a constraint, unique constraint, database is not allowing same records again to that table. Thanks for watching this video.